Hey you guys, it's Peter, and welcome to my channel Peterisms, where I tell stories of my life and just little things that I've learned as I've grown into the person that I am today. And today I want to tell a different kind of story on here. I want to tell somebody else's story. And they shared it with me via a direct message on Twitter. They said that I could share their name and I could share their story, so thank you. It's about a young lady named Steph. And I think it's a really important story to share because it offers hope. And I think that hope is something that often in life we don't have a lot of. You know, I think we look a lot at negativity. We look at bad things that have happened to other people. And we say, oh, these things are going to happen to us. And we often borrow trouble. You know, that was something that my mother always said to me. You always borrow trouble. You always borrow trouble. It hasn't even happened yet. You know, my old sponsor used to say to me, 90% of the things that I worry about never even happen, right? So very rarely do we look at hope. So I want to offer a story of hope for you guys today. Before I get into this, I want to say two things. This video is in no way meant to be self-congratulatory to myself. I didn't really do anything in the grand scheme of things, and I think you'll see that. I just sent her back two sentences. It really wasn't that deep. And the other thing is that I specifically sit down and spend 2 to 3 hours a day responding to social media, you know, Snapchat and emails and direct messages on Twitter and things like that. And I do my best to try to get back to messages. It means so much to me that you guys even reach out to me and you think that I have some kind of impact on your life, positive or negative. So I try to respond to those. So if I haven't responded to you, know that I'm trying to get down to the depths of all of that. But I do want you to know how much all of that means to me. So thank you. Let me tell you what happened. Okay, so let me get into my Twitter. I had it all queued up. Then my husband texted me. That happens sometimes in the real world. On December 7th of 2017, Steph messaged me and she said, "Peter, my boyfriend broke up with me today and I was blindsided with it. My heart is crushed and the only thing helping me get through this evening are your videos on all of your channels." Thank you, Steph. "You're making me laugh, teaching me important lessons, and sharing a good cry with me. It's just like spending time with a good friend. Thank you for you. I'm so sad and can't do anything to change or stop what is happening, but your videos are keeping me from getting too into my own head." Now, I would like to tell you that I don't get a lot of messages like this, but I seem to get a lot of breakup messages. I get a lot of messages from people that will say, "My boyfriend broke up with me tonight," or "My wife left," or "My husband left." And you know what's interesting is, one of the common messages that I get from people is that, you know, I always think that it's a lot of women that watch my videos. And if I look at my analytics, that's true. But often women watch my videos with their husbands or boyfriends at the end of the day, which is just so cool to me, you know, because it's very much like what Alex and I do at the end of our day. I mean, we don't watch YouTube videos together, but we watch TV together and things like that. And so the fact that people allow me in their home to share part of their life, I mean, it's just, it's amazing. And this weekend is 2 years since I really started on YouTube. So it's just, I don't know, all of it's very surreal to me. But I get a lot of husbands and boyfriends that will message me, like if they're going through a divorce or a breakup, and they'll say, "You know, my girlfriend and I used to watch your videos together and we broke up and she left, but I still watch your videos and thank you for what you say in there. It's really helping me get through a tough time." So it's really cool, you know, I mean, that's not cool. I feel bad for people, but it's really cool that all kinds of people are watching my videos. I never thought that would be the case, you know? I never thought that just something simple that I might say might be something that would stick to people, you know? The fact that I say beast in my drama videos and people now on a daily basis say it in their own lives, in their homes, and it makes them smile and laugh. The power of one word, which I didn't even come up with that word. I stole it from Alyssa Edwards on RuPaul's Drag Race. So, you know, like, sometimes just to say little things to people really profoundly changes something in what they're seeing, you know? So the reason I'm sharing this is not because I'm the greatest thing since sliced bread, because I think we all know that's not true. I fuck up on a regular basis. But for you, that in your regular life, you know, if people in your life are having a tough time, just to even say, "Hey, I'm sorry you're having a bad day," you know, or "I'm sorry this happened to you." Sometimes other people don't ever hear that from anybody else. And even though it's not our place to say, "I'm sorry this happened to you," or whatever, because we didn't cause it, it makes other people feel better. It's made me feel better sometimes when people at least acknowledge that I'm going through something shitty, right? So all I messaged her back, And it was like 6 days later, I messaged her back too. I said, hey there, Steph. I am so sorry to hear about your breakup. Hang in there, babe. Better times ahead, I promise, right? And that's a tough promise because I don't know that, right? I mean, I don't know that better times are ahead. I hope they are. And I think sometimes we need to hear that, you know? Sometimes we need to fake it till we make it and realize that even though we're going through the hardest time of our entire life, you know? I remember when I broke up with my first boyfriend or he, you know, we broke up together or whatever. And, I just, you know, it was such a hard time for me. Every day was so difficult. And I thought to myself, I can never imagine myself not living with him in my life. And he was the one that initiated the breakup, you know? But I was like, I can't imagine ever living without him in my life. And the reality was we had gone two separate directions. He wanted one thing and I wanted something else, you know? So we wouldn't have worked anyway. And I can remember those days of sitting there and thinking to myself, I'm never going to have anything like this again. I can remember saying it to my mom, you know. We would watch Jerry Springer and I'd say, how does this woman have two men fighting for her, but I can't even get one? And she'd say, well, I mean, do you want either of these men that are fighting over her? I'd be like, well, no. You know, but I mean, like, you know, I constantly compared my, it seemed like everywhere I went, I saw couples together, you know, and I thought, I'm never going to be a couple again. My mom said something very valuable to me at that time. And she said, you know, none of us are promised a partner in life. But today I have a partner in my life, you know, and this is my third long-term relationship that I've been in. And, you know, it's, things, there are better times ahead, whether you're single and you get to travel with your girlfriends or boyfriends or, you know, boyfriends. But you know what I'm saying? Like, there are going to be better times ahead. You're going to laugh again. You're going to see a TV show that's going to make you smile. Something's going to happen, you know? So she messaged me back and she said, thank you for taking the time out to reply. Petermont, you are good people. Sometimes I am. Thank you. So Tuesday, I received this message from her. Peter, I wanted to thank you for the kind words you said to me back in December. Now remember, all I said to her was two sentences, okay? It didn't even take anything other than that. You were right, better times are ahead. I'm glad that guy broke up with me because I met someone better suited not long after, and guess what? We are getting married this October. Also, thank you for loving smaller YouTubers. I am a small YouTuber and I really appreciate you saying folks might want to try the smaller creators out. I heard a neat term yesterday for small YouTubers, micro-influencers. Isn't that neat? I felt special being called that. Anyways, Peter, you're amazing and really appreciate that. Thank you for all you do on YouTube and personally when responding to fans. And thank you so much, Steph, for saying that to me. But, like, that is hope, okay? You know, like, in December, she thought, like, her life was over. You know, she was in this relationship. She broke up. She didn't know how she was going to go on. She was devastated. And now, look, okay? You know, what is that? 9 months later? 9 months later, they're getting married. Like, okay, slow down a little bit. But 9 months later, they're getting married. I don't know. My husband and I started dating in August, and I proposed to him in June. So, I don't know if I think that that's that soon, you know? Excuse me. I have known couples that met, got married literally 2 months later, and they've been together for 20 or 30 years, and they're like some of the happiest couples I know. Who knows, love? I don't know, love, okay? I'm not anybody to tell somebody how to wait, how long to wait or whatever, you know? But I think that that's important, and I want to get that message out there. I talk so much on my channel about how to deal with negativity and how to deal with toxicity and, you know, all this kind of stuff, but I want to talk more about chasing your dreams and making your life of your dreams come true and how to have hope and how to believe that you deserve to have this amazing life, you know? When I was talking about positivity and negativity the other day in my video, there was a comment that stood out to me, and I'm going to make a specific video about this soon. But the comment was, how do you find these people, okay? How do you find these positive people? And it just kind of took me off guard when I read the comment. I thought, that is really such a profound question, you know, to ask somebody, I want to have positive people in my life, but how do I find them? How do I find a partner that is better suited for me than my last partner was? You know, how do I find friends around me that treat me the way that they should? You know, well, it's similar to how we find a career. We go into a career sometimes, you know, thinking this is what I really want to do. And then we get it in and we think this wasn't what I wanted to do at all. And that's kind of, I think, the art of meeting people. You know, I'm not great at that. I meet somebody, start talking to them. We go out for coffee and I instantly want to be best friends and text all the time. I'm like not great with that at all. Okay. So you might want to stand back. If all these people say they want to be my friend, I'm like, listen, I can become a friend stalker very quickly. But you know what I mean? Like I'm in it to win it. So I get my feelings hurt a lot by people because I trust so easily, you know? Now, I've learned to have a better picker over time. on who I allow in my inner circle and who I allow to be around me. When I meet people and, you know, I'm asking them questions because it's reciprocal, and then they ask me questions about myself too, and they honestly seem interested in what I do, you know, then I have to say, this is a person that takes interest in me as well as me taking interest in them, you know? There are also people that when I say to them, I'm having a bad day, they say to me in return, I'm really sorry. Because sometimes what, you know, friendships are about are the small things. It's not the big things. You know, it's the movie, did you ever see the movie One True Thing? I think it was, that's what it's called, with Meryl Streep and Renee Zellweger. And Meryl Streep has cancer in it. And there's a scene when they go to pick up a friend of Meryl Streep's. And Renee Zellweger's like, why do we pick up this friend? And she said, she doesn't leave her house since her husband left, and so once a week, one of us goes over there, gets her, drives around, we sing songs, and we just get her out of her house and get her out of herself. That's what true friends do that care about you. They get you out of yourself a little bit, they allow you to enjoy life, and they are an asset to your life. They don't bring you down, they don't cause you problems, and they don't cause you pain. They're an asset to your life. We can all be an asset to somebody in their life. We can bring anybody out there a little bit of positivity, and it doesn't take a whole lot, you know? Anyway, I hope you guys are having a wonderful beginning of your weekend. I love you, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.